everyone. My name is Victoria, and today we're going to make green borscht. This is very, very famous dish in Ukraine and Russia, Sorrel, that looks like that, and that it's growing all over Russia and Ukraine, and it's multi-year plant that comes every year, so it's very cost-effective, and a lot of people love it. It has lemony flavor to it, and it's just amazing. So let's get started.
To the heavy bottom pot, add oil. Now I'm using avocado oil because it's high smoky point oil. Some of the recipes call for olive oil, but don't use extra virgin olive oil because it will burn. About a tablespoon or two. To the oil, add onion. Chopped. Now, I like onion, not too much onion. So it's half of pretty small onion. Most of the recipes call for medium onion, whole one or big one. It's up to you. I really like not more than that. And let it caramelize on one side. And I mean it. Let it quite a bit, to get quite a bit color. At this point, if you use meat, add your pieces of meat and let it color with the onion. You can use pork, you can use chicken or chicken breast or chicken thighs, which I love much more. But you don't have to. I like it pretty much meatless, this soup. So as you see, it started to get color. You see? Now, there are people that love it very dark color because it brings a lot of flavor, and I'm not. To this, add carrot and potatoes. Mix it in. The smell is magnifico. Cover the vegetables with water. I'm going to chop inside stalks of baby dill. Why stalks? Because stalks have the most flavor, and when you cook it in the soups, it gives the most flavor. And the leaves, you know, the gentle leaves, you can put in very end just for extra color and extra freshness, fresh flavor. But this one will give so much body to the dish. Now you can use parsley, cilantro, it's up to you. But if you use stalks, which is, you know, very cost effective, and you use all the dill, you're not throwing anything, and the flavors are way better here. At this point, I'm going to add frozen defrosted sorrel. Yes, I think you should say it like this. And this is what makes the soup amazing and actually green borscht. Now, sorrel, as you see, I'm chopping it a little bit because it came full. Sorrel is very savory and sourish leaf. Now, the thing is that you can use, if you can't find sorrel, you easily can use spinach and add lemon, one whole lemon juice, and it will give the same flavor-ish, but not exactly. And yeah, but if you can find sorrel, please use sorrel, it's amazing. Now I'm going to add, this is Chinese celery. Now, you don't have to use Chinese celery, you can use a couple of stalks of regular celery, but Chinese celery, as you see, you use a lot of leafage. And I feel that the flavors of celery is way more pronounced than regular celery. Again, the original recipes doesn't call for it, but I found the flavors work so well, and it gives even more this intense green color to this dish, which is just amazing. Okay, black pepper is quite important in here. I really love black pepper. And it's, as you see, freshly ground, and use quite a lot because it's, you don't have a lot of flavors, I mean not a lot of spices, but black pepper adds a lot of things. And salt, about a teaspoon or so, or to taste. You can start with half a teaspoon, it depends on your liking. And that's it for now. Pop the lid on and let it simmer for about 20 minutes or until potato is done. Because, you know what, it's such an easy recipe that you throw everything in. And because I'm not using any meat, it cooks very fast. So at about 20 minutes simmer will be totally fine for this soup. One thing that I forgot to mention here, add about 3 tablespoons of rice. Now, it's make it so thick and beautiful, you have no idea. And again, it's gluten-free, and it's if it's important for you. And it's just give this thickness without really, you know, overwhelming flavor. And we really love rice inside our soups. And I think this soup is amazing for that. Yep. So yeah, let it cook until potatoes are done, and that's it. That's it, the potatoes are done. Mix it a bit, because when you mix it, the starches from the rice and potatoes go inside the soup and it's thickening the soup. After you close the heat, add garlic cloves. Now here I am having 2 garlic cloves. Now, what it does when you do it after you close the heat, the garlic will cook from residual heat, but the flavor will stay remain a bit fresh and garlicky and not overcooked and sweet, which is tasty by itself. But in here I found that I love more the type of fresher. Now, it's not going to be fresh and it's not going to be pungent, but the smell, yeah, I'm mixing with it. I want to all my garlic go inside. So yeah, garlic goes inside. And add fresh dill now. What it does, it brings a lot of flavor and again, a lot of vibrancy. You can add up to whole bunch of dill here. You see, it's just brings everything alive. And it smells so good. Like I wish you could smell what I'm smelling now.
Serve the borscht warm or cold with a hard-boiled egg on top, sour cream, Greek yogurt, or even mayo. Some people love it with mayo, which I don't recommend. But, you know, everyone to its own. I hope you will give it a go. And don't forget to subscribe, write me a comment, thumbs up me, and cheers a loving life, and see you next time. And remember, go towards your joy and do something fun every day. Bye!